Hi, welcome to Fact Friday. This week I want to talk about contiguity, also known as temporal contiguity. And I hope you all know that the word temporal refers to time. And with contiguity specifically, it's the proximity in time between two stimuli or a stimulus and a response. And how close they occur in time together results in a specific association. And that association is something we can see in both respondent and operant conditioning. In fact, that relationship is It has different factors for both. Let's start with respondent conditioning. In respondent conditioning, temporal contiguity refers to the closeness in time of the neutral stimulus and the conditioned stimulus. So if you remember Pavlov and his good old dog, what Pavlov did was a respondent conditioning procedure in which he paired together a neutral stimulus and an unconditioned stimulus, meat powder and the bell, together very, very close in time. And as a result, that bell was conditioned to be a stimulus that elicits this reflex, this conditioned response. So we know that that closeness in time was a crucial piece in that respondent conditioning, in that pairing. Because what happened as a result? That dog started to salivate in the presence of a bell, something that was previously neutral. But again, because that neutral stimulus so close in time to that unconditioned stimulus, it was able to actually become conditioned to elicit this reflexive response. Versus operant conditioning. Now here, temporal contiguity has to do with the closeness in time of the behavior and the consequence. And I know you all know how important that relationship is. That timing is crucial. It has to be super close in time. The closer, the better. Otherwise, that response is not going to be reinforced. That behavior is not going to increase in the future as a result of that reinforcement. So contiguity, again, has to do with proximity in time between in respondent conditioning, the neutral and the unconditioned stimulus, how close together they are, and in operant conditioning, how close together in time the response is to the reinforcer that follows it. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you guys next time.